So we've completed our continuity of CPC test. At the same time, we've included polarity, and now we're moving on to our insulation resistance test. Our tails are connected to the supply authority's metering equipment and, importantly, its earth. However, the supply for the installation is still isolated. If at this stage you didn't know whether it was isolated, you'd need to perform the safe isolation to prove the consumer unit was dead. As well as proving the consumer unit is isolated, you must remove all loads before carrying out this test. We can see the lamp is fitted in the lighting point behind me, and that would need to be removed. That is connected across line and neutral and will cause us issues during the test. More importantly, sensitive electronic items need to be removed, such as smoke detectors, digital time clocks, TVs, etc., because the test voltage for this is 500 volts DC, and we wouldn't want to pass through sensitive electronic items that test voltage because it can damage them. Equally, we want to pass 500 volts DC through our RCCB, which also contains electronic items, and we must ensure this is turned off during the test. So I'm going to set up my Megger MFT in order to perform the insulation resistance test. To do this, I'll need to rotate around into the red scale here, which is accompanied by the large M and the omega symbol for megohms, mega standing for million. The circuit that I've installed is a 230 volt single phase lighting circuit. If I'd installed a three-phase 400 volt circuit, the test voltage for insulation resistance is exactly the same. The test voltage is 500 volts. So I need to rotate round to 500 volts, and that's 500 volts DC going to be passed through the circuit under test. As before, I need to insert my leads. I'm going to be using the red and green sections as I did before for this test. Again, it doesn't matter if I use the blue lead, but I must go in the red and green holes provided. So we'll use red and green leads. And they're inserted like so. I'm going to make sure that my leads haven't broken. Often they can break or become damaged down this end, because if my leads didn't have continuity, it would give me a false reading during the test. A false reading in this case could be one that's very good. So I'm going to link together my crocodile clips, and I'm going to test that circuit, which is just the leads, and hopefully I'll have zero, in other words, a dead short. I have. If my leads were broken, so let's just disconnect them, we'd be measuring the insulation resistance between here, which is a fantastic, huge resistance between my leads. So you'll see now my reading is infinity, or greater than the scale of the machine, so greater than 999 megohms. So a broken lead can often lead to a reading that we think is fantastic during insulation resistance. So care must be taken to prove that the leads themselves have continuity by doing that test first. So I shorted them together and got a reading of zero megohms. I'm now ready to carry out the test. So we're going to perform our insulation resistance test. So why are we performing that test? What we're trying to do is prove that the cables in circuit, so the cables in this case feeding my light and switch, have not deteriorated over time or become damaged during the installation process in this case, because it's a brand new installation. We're actually trying to prove lack of continuity. So we're trying to prove the line and neutral are not connected together and the live conductors are not connected to, in this case, a circuit protective conductor. So the insulation resistance test should give a fantastically high reading that these circuits are not connected together. The smallest acceptable value of insulation resistance is 1 megohm or 1 million ohms. However, BS7671 says that when the reading falls to below 2 megohms, further investigation is required. This is a brand new installation where I believe the conductor insulation material should not be damaged or deteriorated. So we're probably expecting a reading in the hundreds of megohms. Let's see what reading we get. So we said before starting the test, all loads need to be removed. So I'll do that at this stage. The lamp in this case needs to be removed, which is naturally connected across line and neutral. We also said there's some sensitive electronic components in our RCCB, so that will need to be turned off. We're going to carry out our insulation resistance test from the top of the circuit breaker. However, the test doesn't realise it's got to go out and do the circuit. It actually goes both ways. Therefore, if we left it on, it would pass the 500 volts back through the circuit breaker and back across the RCCB with the electronic components in it. So equally, that needs to be turned off before we can do the test. There is no correct sequence for doing this test, so I don't mind which order in which we do it. We'll be doing between line and neutral, line and CPC, and CPC and neutral. But it doesn't matter which order in which we do it in. So let's see that test. So it doesn't matter which order in which I'm going to do this test. I'm going to do it from the top of the circuit breaker, picking up the line conductor, anywhere on the neutral bar and anywhere on the earth bar. They're solid brass bars, therefore it doesn't matter where I connect my probe. First of all, I'm going to connect across the top of the circuit breaker to pick up my line connection. I'll try and get my fingers out of the way as best as I can, and then onto the neutral bar. Press and hold my test button, and my reading has gone off the scale of the machine, so it's greater than 999 megohms. The smallest acceptable value of installation resistance is 1 megohm. We've got a brand new installation. I expect my reading to be a huge reading. I don't expect the cable insulation materials to have started to break down over time or been damaged during the installation process. Next, I'm going to test between the line and CPC. Back in the top of the breaker, anywhere on the earth bar. Press and hold. Again, greater than 999 megohms. And then finally, between the neutral bar and the CPC, greater than 999 megohms. The smallest acceptable insulation resistance is 1 megohm. Further investigation when it falls below 2. A brand new installation, we expect it to be a huge resistance. The cable hasn't deteriorated or broken down over time. I hope this has been some help.